build a stone wall in the middle of the woods. Start peeling it back and you discover that there was a whole economy. If you look closely at the architecture, you'll see there's a couple of dozen houses from the, you know, the 19th century that were a set, and they were workers' houses. So there was meaning to this little village, and it related to this, but 90 years later, this has virtually been erased. It was an industrial site, but now to look at it, this is a rather wild site.
Fortunately, a lot of people now don't see Rattlesnake Brook, but when we had a little tour along some of the damaged sections of it, they all had stories about fly fishing when they were younger. So they have fond memories of the trout in there, and it flows almost entirely through protected land, land trust land, state land.
We have to address this failing dam. It's not terribly dangerous, but it's a failing dam, and you know, the 2010 floods showed that this waterway impacts local traffic, local residents, because it washed out the road. That, in a sense, is one of the more important, I think, perspectives that the community has on Rattlesnake Brook. We've worked with a particular engineering company, and you know, their opinion was, well, the easiest solution would be to just repair the dam. And you know, we're looking at it saying, there's one approach, but let's go back farther in terms of look at the history of the place, look at the ecology of the place. We don't really need this water supply. We don't need this impoundment for anything in particular. So does it make sense to just repair it for the sake of repairing it and be married to a lifetime of maintenance? So we did a feasibility study. We got more information. We incorporated the history, because you have to have some knowledge of the site in order to examine what the feasibility is to bring it back to a natural environment.
Nature has a way of bouncing back from all of these abuses, man-made and natural, hurricanes, floods, things of that type. It's amazingly resilient. It's just shocking when you think that this forest is nothing like the forest that was here when the first Europeans landed, and probably not the waterways. It bounces back a lot quicker, the whole environment, when man hasn't completely messed things up.
They manipulated the brook, they dammed it. This was a bleachery. So during the late part of the 19th century, early 20th century, this is an industrial site. Engineers say, well, it's going to cost you more to breach it than it is going to be to repair it. And that makes no sense. But you have to go through it. It's a step-by-step process to get to the point where you can actually bring all the numbers to bear, bring the science to bear, do the engineering, the design. It's in the ballpark of as much to repair it. But at the end of the day, we've repaired the land instead of repairing the dam.